friends, welcome to Gut Health with Dr. Gold. We're going to be doing a detox for our abdomen. So if you feel bloated or just a little gassy, this is a great little massage for your stomach, your abdomen. I did learn it in Thailand. It's part of Thai massage. It's so healthy. I'm going to do this standing, but you can remain seated while you do this, or preferably lying down on your back. So you want to get your abdomen ready. You're going to just rub your hands together to warm them up. And yes, you can use a little heating pad. Just put a towel down first. Make sure you test it and make sure it's not too hot. And then just with warm hands, just gently rest them on your belly, taking a nice deep breath in and a nice long exhale out. You can watch my belly. I'm inhaling, inflating the belly, allowing it to rise. Exhale, empty the belly, letting it go. Good. Deep breath in. You can do this for about 30 seconds or until your belly feels at ease or you're feeling a little bit better, just a little calmer, relax. Start to smile to feel better. And then we're going to use kind of the notch of that thumb, to knuckle, to just gently press right below the belly button. So as you exhale, the belly contracts, and you just gently knead inside as you inhale, and then exhale. Good. Inhale, and exhale, release. You can have somebody else do it on you. If they do use their palms, it's going to be the heel of the hand to press in. So if somebody else is doing it, just have them gently press onto your belly. Feels nice. I've been trying to teach my cat how to do this. He hasn't figured it out just yet. My other cat used to just paw my belly, put a towel on first so it didn't claw me, and he would just paw me. Felt so good. Okay, take another nice deep breath. And then what you're going to do as the colon runs clockwise, we have the sigmoid, we have the ascending, so this is the large colon that we're talking about, ascending, transverse, and descending colon. So we're just going to go in a clockwise direction through your belly. So we inhale and then gently exhale. Again, if you're doing it on yourself, I use the knuckles. If somebody else is doing it on you, just the heel of the hand. Inhale with a big smile and then exhale. Good. Just keep going. Feels so good. You'll find certain spots if you're like, whoa, I really need to spend a little more time here. Feel free to do that. And gently in the center. This is where I feel it right now. Close to my time of the month. And then gently over to the other side. Good. And feel free, you can always switch hands if it's a little bit easier for you. Inhaling and then exhaling. Good. After you do that all the way around, so circle completely, you can gently rub your hands again. Gently place them on the abdomen. Breathe into it. See the areas relaxing. And then I just gently massage the area. You know when they say rub-a-dub-dub, give me the grub, or yummy, 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 yummy for my tummy? We've seen people, maybe you haven't seen it, but my husband does that sometimes. It's so cute. So anything to rub around the belly feels, to give it love, to know that it's appreciated, it works really hard. You know, our abdomen has many neurotransmitters that affect our mood, affects our health. 70% of the immune system, the IgA, antibodies can be found in the gut, in the abdomen, in the intestines. So really, really important that we make sure we have good bowel movements. I know sometimes it's not a topic we want to discuss. Kids laugh when we say poop or fart, but again, if you're not getting those regular bowel movements, it can be very, very touchy. It's not fun. You feel irritable, cranky. Make sure you're hydrating, exercising, even if you can't really move as much, gentle range of motion or gentle stretches or breathing techniques, even laughter can help with that gut. It's great for menstrual cramps. If you know people suffering with dysmenorrhea, even menopausal symptoms are so hot, you might say, I'm so hot, I don't want to put heat. You can put just cool compresses on that belly with a gentle massage. Most important, or you can just do it in a cool room while your hands are gently touching your belly. Good. Shake it out. Roll the shoulders back. face, lengthening the spine, upright posture. And when we slouch, we can contort our belly to protrude forward. But if we lengthen and extend, we can slim down a little bit. This is a nice stretch to release the shoulders, stretch out the belly a little bit, and then just gently massage one more time. You did it! I'm so, so proud of you. Mwah! It's Dr. Gold, the Dr. Gold Optimal Living Institute. Sharing with you gut health, so important. I also recommend functional medicine testing. This is much more than just an endoscopy or colonoscopy, which is also important. Those I think of as a picture, looking at the colon. The functional medicine test, like the GIFX profile from Genova Diagnostics, actually looks at the microbiome. It's all the bacteria, the fungi, the viruses that live within. It's like a whole community of trillions of organisms, much more on the inside in our gut than we even have on cells on our body. So these trillions of organisms affect our health. If they play nice, we're eating healthy, good nutrition, not so much stress, not so many pollutants, environmental pollutants, or skin products that we're using are healthy for our skin, like coconut oil and other stuff, jojoba oil. But putting good stuff in, this microbiome can be very diverse, abundant, and feel good. We have regular bowel movements, our energy is high, we don't really have many gut issues, we're able to digest. And remember, it's what you absorb. So absorb, digest the food, and comes out with all the toxins released. That's a good thing. But if you're gaining weight, especially a lot of belly fat, you're irritable, you're cranky, your belly's cranky and bloated, that's your body talking to you that you need to get that investigated. And then that exam, the GIFX profile, or if you use another testing site, they can actually look for inflammation, the diversity of your microbiome, all those bacteria. Do you have more of the good bacteria versus the bad? Remember, steroids, antibiotics can kill the good bacteria. And just taking a probiotic doesn't replenish all that you've lost. So it's good to actually check what your body needs. Instead of guessing, because I have patients taking probiotics, which is nice, but which ones do you take? How much do you take? So you can actually have objective testing to identify more specifically what your body needs. I do recommend that for many of my patients, especially those suffering with gut health issues, or for those that want to be more proactive in their health. It's good to remember, you don't always feel bad. Think of that patient who had a heart attack or a stroke. The week before, if they were not in the hospital, they probably felt okay or not that bad to get investigated or evaluated. If they felt bad or knew they were having a heart attack or stroke, they'd be in the hospital. So we don't always feel bad until later when the symptoms are severe. You don't want to wait for that. The gut test can pick up early markers, make sure you're digesting food well, because if you're not, you can be more prone to disease. So we can prevent something a lot easier than waiting to treat it. Again, have a beautiful day. Live optimally. Empower your health. Lots of love, everyone. Take care, and feel free to message me with any questions. Dr. Gold with Dr. Gold's Optimal Living Institute. I'm a medical doctor, also in part of the A4M Fellowship in Florida, and also, well, it's all over, but I've been going to their conferences, their headquarters, local, and oh, functional medicine, integrative doctor, and board certified holistic medicine, and board certified in family medicine, and a registered yoga teacher and laughter yoga leader. Yeah, it's a mouthful, I know. And also study NLP or neurolinguistic programming, which is conscious hypnosis. Have a beautiful day. Live optimally.